on which water has collected. You see, the depression, it can be large or small, on which there is accumulation of water inside it, then we call it what? Lake. So there are different type of lake formed due to origin or modal formation. So we will see different type of lake according to what happened on the land. See, for instance, if it is erosion that occurred on the land and caused that type of lake, it means we call erosion is the origin or modal formation of that lake. If it is the deposition that caused the occurrence or the presence of that lake, it means we will call deposition is the origin or modal formation of that lake. So as I said, depression on the land surface on which water has collected, we call it what? Lake. So lake, this it is the definition of lake. Lake refers to the depression on the land surface on which there is accumulation of water. Let's say this it is the land, then we found right here there is what? The downwarp of the land, you see? For instance, right here there is the downwarp of the land. So once this open space becomes filled with water, it means the accumulation of water inside the depression like this one, then we call it what? The lake. That's why you say refer to the depression on the land surface on which water has collected. Then from there, let us go direct to what happened on the land surface. It means we have different process that has occurred on the land surface and is resulted to the formation of different type of lake. So let's see lakes according to the modi of formation. Lake according to the modi of formation or lacking according to origin. What caused the formation of that lake? We call lake according to the mode of formation or lake according to what? To origin. So we can classify lakes due to plate movement is the first type of lake. We can classify lake according to volcanic activities. See, as the second group of lake, we can classify lake according to erosion. See, and lastly, you can classify lake according to deposition. Thereafter, these are the major classification of lake based on what? Based on mode of formation or origin. So we have lake due to plate movement, we have lake due to volcanic activities, we have lake due to erosion, as well as lake due to deposition. There we will see other or minor type of lake, where we'll discuss about man-made lakes, lakes constructed by man is a result of the construction of dams, where the enlargement of dams turned into lakes. Then we have the vegetation dams lake. It means right now there will be the accumulation of different vegetation over the land surface, which blocks the flowing of river, for instance, or water bodies. And then the accumulation of water occurs as a result of the accumulation of vegetation over the given area. And we call it the vegetation dam lake. Thereafter, we will see what we call the calcareous lake. It means the accumulation different depression on the karst region. Sometime they may be forming what we call lake. So those are the minor or other type of lake. But right now we have the major type of lake, where our question will, or our discussion will stick to it. Well, are we together? Okay, let us see different lakes according to mode of formation or origin. As I said earlier, that we are going to see or to classify lake according to what happened to the land, what happened to the earth's crust, you see? So we start the plate movement or earth movement lakes. It means these are lakes formed after either divergence or convergence or upward movement and downward movement of the land. So what happened? We know during plate movement or continental drift movement, it means there was the movement of the land. So the movement of the land, they may leave what we call the depression. So once the depression is filled or with the water, then we call it the plate movement or the earth movement lakes. So we have two types of earth movement lakes. We have the Rift Valley lakes and the Downwarpy, sometimes we call them the Basin lakes. Okay, so let's start with Rift Valley lakes. It means Rift Valley lakes, these are the lakes formed when the land surface is moved away from each other, caused by the lateral forces known as the tensional forces. It means, let's assume this is our land, you see, this is our S crust. So, when the lateral forces act upon the S crust, two effects may occur, or two processes may occur. One, let us assume this is tensional forces. So if tensional forces act upon the crust, as you can see right now, it means the crust may move away from each other, and later may result to the formation of a gap. See, may result to the formation of the gap. So the gap formed after the movement of the plate away from each other, it means that gap that occurred, we call it the Rift Valley. So once the Rift Valley become flooded with water, then we call the Rift Valley lakes, as you can see right now. It means this land has pulled away from this land, and then it occurred a gap right there. This gap right here we call it the Rift Valley. So Rift Valley, it's a valley formed after the crust or the land surface has moved away from each other. So once the Rift Valley become flooded or filled with water, then we call what? The Rift Valley lakes. Example, Rift Valley lakes are Lake Tanganyika, Nyasa or Malawi, Tanganyika. These are example of Rift Valley lakes. Nyasa, Rudolf, or they call it Tunkang Lake, etc. These are Rift Valley lakes. See, then from there, okay, let us see a simple image of what is Rift Valley lakes. As you can see right here, we have the crust, this one. Then the crust undergoes what we call the lateral forces, the tensional forces. Then the tensional force pull up away the acid crust, and to create a gap between the acid crust. So the gap formed right here, we call it the Rift Valley. So once the Rift Valley become flooded or filled with water, we call the Rift Valley lakes, as I have explained. Then after that, so let's assume this part of the Rift Valley right now, this one. This part of Rift Valley get weird away. So once this part of the Rift Valley get weird away, it form what we call a basin. Lake Victoria is an example of basin lake. What happened? Let me demonstrate by drawing right here. What happened to Lake Victoria? See? So the Downwarpy lake. It means the Downwarpy, the second part of the earth movement lake, we call it the Downwarpy or the Basin lake. The Downwarpy lake. These are the lakes formed when part of the land surface got downwarp. Or it, there is a movement of the land, downward movement of the land. So we assume this is our acid crust, see? So it means what happened to the acid crust, it means there is the downward forces, the vertical forces, see? It acts upon the acid crust. So if the forces, the vertical forces will act upon this crust, automatically this point of the land will downwarp. You see? Once it's downwarp, it means it will leave the gap. The gap may be called what? The Basin Lake. Example of the Basin Lake, as I said earlier, is what we call the Lake Victoria. Lake Victoria is an example of what? Of the Basin Lake. Formed after the downwarping of what? Of the land. Leaving the gap, then the gap becomes flooded with what? With water, then we call the Basin Lake. This one. As you can see, it means this part of the land was downwarped. There was the downward movement of the land, which later leaves
a shape, I mean the thin shape, a large circular shape. Then once this becomes flooded water right here, then we call what? We call it the Basin Lake. Example of the Basin Lake is Lake Victoria. Lake Victoria is an example of down of the Basin Lake. Then we go to the second type of what? Of lake. The second classification of lakes according to model formation is volcanic lakes. It means these are the lakes formed when volcanic, there is volcanic, or there was the volcanic eruption which occurred on the land surface, and later it left large depressions on the estuary surface, become flooded or filled with water. Thereafter we have different type of volcanic lake. Start with this one. Right now let's go to what we call the volcanic lakes. It means volcanic lakes, as I've said, refer to the lakes formed refer to the lakes formed after the volcanic eruption has occurred on the land surface, then it left large depression, which then become flooded or filled with water. Then let's see type of volcanic lakes. The first type is crater lake. Crater lake. It means crater lakes, these are the lakes formed when water has occupied the small depression on top of the highland area. You see, what is a crater? A crater, it is a small depression on top of the highland area. See, a small depression on top of the highland area, we call it a crater. So once the crater becomes flooded or filled with water, is what we call the crater lake. As you can see right here, we have the summit, the depression, this one. It is a depression on top of this highland area, which formed as a result of the bombardment away of the plague dome. It means right here there was the plague dome. So the bombardment or the removal of the plague dome, then it left the small depression on top of this highland area. So once the depression becomes flooded water, then we call it the crater lake. Then from there, we have what we call the caldera lake, is type of volcanic lake. So what is caldera lake? Caldera lake refers to the lake formed when water has occupied a small crater inside the caldera. Because we know what is caldera, we refer to the central crater. When I say central crater, it means it's a very large crater which formed after the bombardment away of the large part of it, or sometimes it may occur as a result of the downward of the large part of the land. Then it leaves or how it formed a very large circular depression, call it a caldera. Example of caldera is Ngorongoro crater. You see, that is an example of what you call the caldera. So inside the Ngorongoro crater there, you may find a small depression filled with water. So a small depression filled with water, we call it lake. So the depression that is inside the caldera, we call it the caldera lake. Let me illustrate by using the diagram right here. Let's assume there was this one. It is a caldera, see? A very large circular depression formed due to the downward of the large part of the land. So what happened, we have the caldera right here. It means between the caldera, it may be formed a small depressions, this one, see? So a small depression inside the caldera, this one, we call most of the time it occurs the result of the bombardment of this part of the land. The bombardment of this part of the land caused by the volcanic eruption, it means it may left a small depression inside this large area right here, inside this large circular depression, we call it the caldera. This, it is a caldera. See, this side, an example is the Ngorongoro crater. So this is caldera. Inside the caldera, it may be formed in a small depression after the eruption of this point of the land. It means there was the eruption of the molten material right here. So automatically the eruption of molten material by forceful, in a forceful way, it may push away this point of the land. It may form a small depression inside the caldera. So once that small depression, this one, become flooded or filled with water inside the caldera, then this one is what we call the caldera lake. Not this one. This one is what we call what? The caldera lake. So by definition, what is a caldera lake? Caldera lake, it is a lake formed inside the caldera when the crater become flooded, when the crater inside the caldera become flooded the water inside the caldera. Then let's see the last type of volcanic lakes, the lava land lake. The third one, the lava dammed lake. The lava dammed lakes we refer to the lake formed when the lava flow blocked the river stream. Listen to me very careful. The lava dammed lake is a lake formed when the river, when the lava flow blocked the river stream. Then it hardened and solidified. Then it caused the accumulation of water. See, then the accumulation of water on the land, we call it lake. The lava flow which block the river, I mean the river valley, and solidify, then it accumulated at that area, we call lava dam. Because the word dam in geographic point of view means the accumulation. So lava dam means the accumulation of lava. So what happened? It means right now lava has accumulated across the river valley. Then it caused the water which was flowing toward that direction to accumulate at that point. Then it formed what we call the lava dammed lake. Let me show by using our illustration right here. The lava dammed lake, what is lava dammed lake, as I said, it means, let's assume we have, this is the highland area, for instance, then there was eruption of molten material. Then the eruption of molten material, it means was flowing towards this direction. Are we together? Then let's assume right here there was a river. This was a river. The river was passing this way, see? This, it is a river passing this direction. It means this was the lava flow. Then the lava flow become, and then it blocked the river stream. This was the lava flow, this one. This was the lava flow. Then we say this one. The accumulation of lava at this point, we call lava dammed. Lava dammed. It means the accumulation of lava at this point. Then it solidified and hardened. Then remember, there was the river. This one was the river flow. So if this one was the river flowing towards this direction, then the lava flow is blocking the river, and then it solidified at this point, automatically there will be the accumulation of water at this point right here. See? Caused by what? By the accumulation of lava at this point. You see? So the accumulation of water, this one, on top of the land, we call it lake. So this, in general, we call it the lava dammed lake. This one. Lava dammed what? Lake. Okay, thank you very much. Okay, let's go and see another type of lake. We have finished the Rift Valley lakes. I mean the lake due to earth movement, where we have the Rift Valley lakes as well as the Downward Lake, and you have seen its examples. Then from there, I have right here and explained what we call the volcanic lakes, where we have three type of lakes. I have explained the crater lake, the caldera lake, as well as the lava dammed lake. So let's go and see another type of lake. Okay, the third type of lakes, according to model of origin or model formation, is what we call the erosion lake. So remember, erosion, it occurs as a result of its agent, where its agent can be water, it can be ice, windy, etc., etc. So let's see erosion lakes based on ice. Oh, glacier. We call them the glacial erosion lakes. So, lake due to erosion, that's the third type of lake. The third type of lake is lake due to what? Due to erosion. So, on lake due to erosion, it means, let us base on glacial erosion lakes. Erosion lakes. See? So glacial erosion lakes, it means these are the lakes formed when glacier was occurred on the land surface, and then it resulted to formation of different depressions. So when the depression becomes filled with water, then we call glacial erosion lakes. What happened on the land, it means it occurred erosion. Caused by what? By glacier, the moving ice, which after that it left like depression filled with water, then we call glacial erosion lake. Then an example of glacial erosion lake, or type of glacial erosion lake, one is what we call the Saki lake, or some people they call it the Corrie lake. See? So, water has correlates. It means it has legs formed when the water is occupied the small depression at the bottom of the highland area. We know what is sake. Sake, let us show this is a highland area. You can see right there. See, this is the highland area. See? This is the grass area. So, we have steep slopes. This has a steep slope. See? This has a steep slope. Grass are we together? This has a steep slope. Then we say this part of the land with a steep sided knife edge with steep features. I mean a steep sided knife edge, steep features it is called this. We call them the arid. So this is the arid. So between the arid sometimes it may be formed semicircular depression. So the semicircular depression, this one formed at the bottom of the highland area, this one we call the sake. What happened to the land? It means there was the freezing and the melting of ice repeatedly. Then at the end, it may eventually result to the formation of a semicircular depression at the foot or at the bottom of this highland area. And we call it the sake. This is, it is a sake. So what happened? It means once the sake becomes flooded or filled with water, then it forms the sake or the Korea lake. That's why Korea Lake, it is a lake formed when water has occupied the semicircular. This is a semicircular depression at the foot of the highland area. This is the first type of glacial erosion lake. Then we go to the second type of
glacial erosion lake,
where we call something known as ribbon. Ribbon lake. Or sometimes they call it the trough lake. The trough. Trough lake. See? So what happened? What is a trough? It means the ribbon or trough lake. We refer to the lake formed when water has occupied the elongated depression excavated by ice on the floor of the U-shaped valley. It means there was a U-shaped valley. Then what happened due to the freezing and melting of ice continuously on the floor of the U-shaped valley, then it excavates the floor of the U-shaped valley. Then it leaves the elongated depression. So the elongated depression formed as a result of the excavation of the floor of the U-shaped valley. We call it ribbon. So once the ribbon becomes flooded or filled with water, then it forms what we call the ribbon lake. See?
You are watching Darasa Online.
This is our U-shaped valley, okay? This is our U-shaped valley, as you can see right here. It means this is a U-shaped valley. This is one side of the U-shaped valley. Then this automatically it is a U-shaped valley, as you can see there. This it is the flow of the U-shaped valley. This one, the flow of the U-shaped valley. U-shaped valley. This one. So remembering now, it means there was the movement, the flowing of the glacier, the moving ice. Right now they are moving between the flow of the U-shaped valley. So once the glacier will excavate this point of the land and left the large depression right here, this one. The elongated depression, this one. The elongated depression, which occurs the result of the moving ice right here, this elongated depression we call it the ribbon. You see? Are we together? Then the ribbon, if it will be filled with water, then it turned into lake, and we call it the ribbon lake. Okay, let's see the image of the ribbon lake. As you can see, this it is a very large U-shaped valley caused by the result of the glacier movement on the land surface. So what happened? It means this it is a flow of the U-shaped valley. Then it excavated by the moving ice. Then it left the large depression, as you can see right now, it is filled with water. So this type of lake we call the ribbon lake. In fact, the lake formed when the elongated depression right now is excavated, then it becomes flooded with water on the glaciated area. Then from there, as I said, that we have three types of glacial erosion lakes. The first one is Sakir Lake, as I've explained. We have the ribbon lake, and the last one is the rock basin lake. Rock basin lakes is this as a lake formed when water has occupied the circular depression on the floor
of the U-shaped valley in a glaciated area. It means right now a type of depression in the glacial area. We have the semicircular depression, and we call it the Sakin, as we have seen earlier. We have the elongated depression excavated by ice on the floor of the U-shaped valley, and we call it the ribbon. And lastly, we have the circular depression, see? And we call it the rock basin. So, if a rock basin, it is a circular depression on the glaciated area. It means once the rock basin become filled with water in the glaciated area, then it turned into a lake, and we call it the rock basin what? Lake. So in a simple way, when drawing, I can explain right here. Let's assume this it is a glacial area, and this one is what we call the floor of the U-shaped valley. So what happened? Remember, right now there was the movement of glacier on this floor. It means this one, it is a floor of the what? Of the U-shaped valley in a glaciated area. So as the glacier move down the slope, sometimes they may erode the floor of the U-shaped valley. So if they left a small or large circular depression like this one, see, small or large depression on the floor, the circular depression on the floor of the U-shaped valley in a glaciated area, this we call them what? The ribbon, the rock basin. So once the rock basin becomes flooded water, then it turned into a lake. What type of lake? We call the rock basin lake. Then those are three type of glacial erosion lake. Then let's see other type of erosion agent, which is windy. We have seen ice and its effect, which results to different type of lake, if I explained. Then let's see windy erosion lake as agent of what? Of erosion, windy. Okay. Windy erosion lakes, it occurred in arid and semi-arid area, especially in desert area, where sometimes there was the movement or the blowing of wind from one area to another area. So what happened, it means, the movement of wind over the surface of the desert, especially the sandy desert, sometimes it tends to carry the fine particles of sand somewhere else. So the area where wind erosion has occurred, sometimes it may be left to a large circular depression. We call it the diffraction hollow, and when the depression is small, we call it the diffraction pan. So what happened? It means there was a wind, called it the diffraction wind. It is a circular blowing wind. It blow in a circular way. So what happened? It means once it erode or it take away the loose material, which is sand, it may leave a large circular depression. So once the depression is filled with water, then it turned into a lake. We call it the oasis lake. Are we together? Then what is oasis lake? Oasis lake is the lake formed when water has occupied or has filled the circular depression in arid or in desert area. So in windy erosion lakes, we have what you call the oasis lakes. See, lakes formed when water has occupied what? Water has occupied the circular depression. You see, depression formed by the deflation wind. Formed by the deflation wind. Are you together? So the deflation wind, it means it's just wind which blowing, circulating in a circular way. You see, so once it blow in a circular way, it means it may carry the material, the loose material. And later, let's say there was the sand right here. See, if there was sand right here, it means the wind, once it comes while blowing in a circular way, it may remove this part of the land. It carry away the loose material, which is sand. Later on, it may lift a circular depression. See, this one. So a circular depression on the desert area, we call it what? The deflation pan or deflation hollow. We will call it the deflation hollow if the depression is large, and we will call it the deflation pan if the depression is small. So once this depression becomes filled with water, then we call it what? The oasis lake. All together. So let's see an example of the image of the oasis lake.
As you can see right here, okay, that this one, see? I'm sure you can see it very clearly. we have different palm trees around it. Renault is filled with water. And this point, it is a point where people who travel in desert, sometimes they come and they try to rest in these places. You see, it's a place with lodges, hotels and restaurants, see? So it acts as a resting point, see? Maybe you're traveling from nowhere, then at the middle of the desert, you find the oasis. So right here, it's where you can get hotel, restaurant, you see? So this is an example of what? Of Oasis Lake. As you can see, it is now filled with what? With water.
Okay, we have then three types of lakes. Lakes are due to earth movement, lake due to volcanic activity, and lake due to erosion. So right now, let's see lake due to deposition. As I've said, we have classified lake according to original model formation into four major types. See, lake due to earth movement, lake due to volcanic activity, lake due to erosion. Right now, let's see lake due to what? Lake due to deposition.
Okay. Lakes due to deposition. Lake due to deposition. This is the last type of lake.
So lake due to deposition, we are going to talk about lake due to glacial, because we have the glacial deposition lakes and lake due to river deposition lakes. Listen to me very carefully. Due to deposition means we are going to talk on glacial deposition lakes as well as the river deposition lakes. Okay, let's see the lake due to glacial deposition. It means due to glacial deposition, it means the glacier may shift from one point to another. Remember, glacier refers to the moving ice. See? So once there is a glacier, it means there was the moving ice over the land surface. Sometimes the deposition of heat may result to the formation of different type of lakes. So one type of glacial deposition lake is what we call the moraine dammed lake. Listen to me very careful. We call it the moraine dammed lake. So I told you in geographic point of view, the word dammed will refer to the accumulation. In a very simple way, accumulation, or the natural accumulation of material, we call it dammed. We have seen the lava dammed. It means the accumulation of the hot molten material. We call it the accumulation of lava, the lava dammed. So right now we are talking about the moraine dam. It means the natural accumulation of material carried by what? By glacier. So moraine dammed lake will refer to the lake formed when moraine has blocked the river streams which flow in a valley glacial. Then once it blocks the river stream which flow in a valley glacial, it means the movement of water of the river will now accumulate at where there was a barrier caused by the presence of what? Of moraine. So we call it moraine dammed lake. I repeat, right now we are talking about the moraine dammed lake. It means what is moraine dammed lake? The fact of the lake formed when moraine has accumulated at the end of the valley glacial. Then it caused the river which was flowing in that valley glacial to accumulate instead of continue flowing. Due to what? Due to the deposition or the presence of what? Of moraine. Let's say an example. We have a steep, I mean this one.
Nchi yetu tangu tumepata uhuru ilikuwa na hospitali za wilaya 77 tu. Hivi sasa tunajenga 67. Tukienda kwa mwendo huu, nina uhakika katika muda mfupi uliobaki itakuwa kila wilaya na wilaya zingine zinaweza zikawa na hospitali mbili mbili za wilaya. Tumeongeza bajeti ya dawa na vifaa tiba kutoka shilingi bilioni 31 hadi shilingi bilioni 270 mwaka huu. Aidha tumeajiri watumishi wa afya wapatao 11,152 na pia tumejenga nyumba